we have this problem, okay, and we have to solve this problem. इसको सॉल्व करना है हमको. सो देर आर सिक्स चार्जेस, ओके, विच आर द कॉर्नर्स ऑफ ए रेगुलर हेक्सागन ऑफ साइड डी. ओके, यू हैव टू फाइंड व्हाट शुड बी द चार्ज द सेंटर सो दैट द नेट फोर्स ऑन एनी वन ऑफ द कॉर्नर्स इज जीरो. ओके, सो दिस प्रॉब्लम हैज बीन डिवाइडेड इनटू फोर स्टेप्स. द फर्स्ट स्टेप इज लाइक दिस. सी, यू हैव टू फाइंड द फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू कैलकुलेट द फोर्स ऑन this, say this corner, due to this corner and this corner, okay. So what will be the force on this corner due to this will be this way, force on this corner due to this will be this way. So the that force comes out to be F1 is equal to KQQ by B square, KQQ by that distance square, okay. The angle is 120 degree because it is a regular hexagon, the angle comes out to 120 degree. So how do you calculate the resultant? The resultant F is given by F is equal to F1. If you calculate, it comes out to be F1. What is this F1? KQQ by D square. And how did I calculate this resultant? I calculate this resultant using, you know, parallelogram law of vector addition. Okay, that means F is equal to root over F1 square plus F1 square plus 2 F1 F2 cos 120 degree. So this is how I calculate. Cos 120 degree is equal to minus half. Please remember this. So in the first scenario, I calculated the force due to the charges here and here, which are marked in green. In the second scenario, what I did is I calculated the force on this corner due to this charge and this charge. Okay, so what I got is like this. Force on this Q due to this Q is this way, which is F2, and force on Q due to this charge is radially outwards. So let those two charges be F2. Okay, so if you moreover this angle is 30 degree because this gives you 90 degree, then since the entire angle is 120 degree, so this has to be 30 degree, this also is 30 degrees, and this is also 30 degree, so the entire angle is 120 degree. So if this is 60, then this is 60. So if you calculate the resultant, then what you get is F2 root 3. Okay, and how we do now, F2 can be expressed in terms of F1 using this formula. F2 is nothing but KQQ by D root 3 the whole square. That means this distance and this distance is D root 3. You should by this time know how D root 3 has come about. And so what happens is so F2 can be calculated as QQ by KQQQ by D root 3 the whole square, which is this, okay, KQQ by D root 3 the whole square, which is nothing but F2 is equal to F1 by 3. F1 is KQQ by D square. So we have expressed F2 in terms of F1. So the resultant is F2 root 3, that is equal to F2 has been expressed in terms of F1, that is F1 by 3 into root 3. So you get is F1 by root 3. Now the next step, what you have done is this. Force on this charge due to this is readily outwards, and moreover this distance is nothing but 2a. So what you get is KQQ by 2a square, that is equal to F1 by 4 in terms. So if you express this force, this net resultant in terms of F1. Now the net resultant x this. So you see from this figure the net resultant x away. So in order to counterbalance this force, the charge which should be placed at this center should be a negative charge, so that force on this due to this will be toward the negative charge. So this red color force and the black one should cancel out, then only will the charge at this corner will be in equilibrium. So the net resultant due to this outside charge is given by F1. We have to sum up all the rest three cases, F1 plus F1 by root 3 plus F1 by 4, that is nothing but F1 into 5 by 4 plus 1 by root 3. So if you just use the value of F1, it comes out to KQQ by D square, which is 5. After simplification, you get 5 root 3 plus 4 by 4 root 3. Hence, for the equilibrium of the charges, we can say that this this resultant outside resultant should be equal to the inner force, attractive force. So, and hence they cancel out each other. So, what you get is KQQ by D square, which is nothing but KQ force charge of this and this by the distance is D. By the distance square, which is d square, should be equal to this outer charge, which is KQQ by d square into 5 root 3 plus 4 by 4 root 3. So if you solve, you get this answer. But taking the symbol into taking the sign into consideration, along with the magnitude, we have the charge at the center should be a negative one. So it is Q is equal to minus 5 root 3 by 4, 5 root 3 plus 4 by 4 root 3 into capital Q. So this is the solution of the above problem. I hope you understood this concept. So thank you.